already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Welcome to Power Sewing. I'm Ron Collins.
And I'm Sandra Betzina. Today you're going to learn everything you've ever wanted to know about bias cut garments.
That's a lot.
Well, you know, the reason people love them so much is they're so flattering. The dress I have on is bias. I particularly love linen on the bias because linen can be so stiff.
Right.
And when you cut, this little top is cut on the bias. Okay. So it just hangs better. It's just much nicer. But sometimes you don't have enough fabric. So I just wanted to show you, if you don't have enough fabric to match, you can stick in a little piping on the shoulder to kind of confuse the issue. And then no one notices that it doesn't match perfectly, because sometimes it's hard to get the side seams, the shoulders, everything matching, because it's on the bias, it takes more fabric. All right, so now what I want to show you first of all, though, is we're not cutting it out of linen. We decided to make it a little more difficult.
This looks like a bad boy
fabric. Oh, this is a bad boy. Mm. This is a silk fabric. And when you're cutting something on the bias, you're going to be cutting it singly. So that means that we're going to put this bias on the paper. We're going to put the fabric on the paper and then cut it out. Now, this is always the way I cut slippery fabrics. I put tissue paper, you know, this is just wrapping paper, the inside package.
How many layers? You have two?
Even one layer is
okay.
And so I tape it to the end of the table here. And ordinarily, I'd have it taped to the end of the table here.
Maybe we should explain to the people out there what bias is, right?
All right. Well, let's start out. This is a straight grain of fabric. This is the way of how most things are cut. Very few things are cut on the cross grain. It has a little give, but not very much. But bias is on the diagonal. And you can see already how that hangs.
Drapes.
And that's what we want. But if we would just cut this out on a cutting surface as itself, it would be very problematic. So what I do is I take the selvage. Let's see, tape.
Here we go. And you tape.
And we're going to do it single thickness. And I'm going to tape it. You see the cut edge here on one end. And I've got the selvage on the other.
You need more tape, my friend?
This is so worth doing, as you will see in a few minutes. All right, give me a little more paper here. I mean, a little more tape, sorry. Because by doing this, and I have to have a little more at the top, I am sure when I'm cutting it out that I have it exactly on the straight of the grain when I cut it. So I really am getting true bias.
That has a print or a grid system to it, so I can definitely see how
this can
roll.
Oh, we have a lot of challenges with this. Okay, so now for starters, let's sit down and talk about the pattern.
Should we have this hanging over the edge?
Well, it's not. We're going to hang it on our tummies.
Jeez.
Because it's true. You don't want a lot hanging over the edge, but most people don't have a table big enough to accommodate it. Now, when we have our pattern pieces, the first thing you need to do is to take your pattern pieces. And do you see, this is a straight grain pattern that I'm using. So what I have to do is it's cut, do you see, on the fold. You have to make a full pattern piece for all your pieces.
Because you're cutting singly. One layer.
Okay. So what I did is I have a front and a back. The next thing I do is from the pattern, I will take... And I'm only going to stay tape one thing. I want this neckline to stay, this kind of little shouldery part to stay nicely. So I take that and I walk that stay tape around, and that's going to be the stay tape. I'll have one of those for each side.
So you walk that right on the stitching line.
Right where the stitching line will be. Okay? Now the other thing is I have to turn this into bias. So because now it's to be cut on the fold. So what we want to do is we want to take this, and this is the straight of the grain, and then we want to have it perpendicular. Draw a line perpendicular like this. And then anything in between these is bias. So it gets both ways.
Okay.
See, Juan and I always go like that, B for bias. See, it's halfway in between. And there we go. So that's bias. All right, now, this fabric, in addition to cutting it on the bias, now see, ordinarily I'd be cutting it with this straight grain line parallel to the selvage. But because I'm cutting it on the bias and I've drawn the new bias line, I'm going to shift it so one of these lines that say B is a bias. But before I cut it out, I want to do a little measuring, because one of the things about bias is it gets long and skinny, and people say, oh, bias is too figure revealing. Well, we're going to check to see how figure revealing it is. First of all, I cut out my size, and then what I do, see, if my size is here, all right, in about the tummy area, that's everybody has a problem area. So between the seam lines, do you see, I will cut this. So this measures 20. Okay, so 20 on this, and then I measure the back piece, and I already measured that. So that's 21 inches on one and 20 on the other. Okay?
Okay.
So that's 41 inches. Now I am 37 inches, and that would be just about right, because you like 4 or 5 inches more, because when it gets on the body, it's, now suppose it wasn't
bigger. It hangs closer to the body, doesn't it?
So if there wasn't enough, you see, instead of using this size, I'd come out the next size.
Okay.
Now, I wouldn't come out the next size everywhere, just starting at the bust.
The problem areas.
Yeah. So just, now, the other thing is, most patterns are not set up to be sewn on the bias. They just have a 5/8 of an inch seam. And if you sew a 5/8 of an inch seam on bias, it stretches and gets wobbly. So what I do is I add an extra inch.
To the 5/8.
To the 5/8. So now my seam is going to be 1 5/8. So now I can lay this on here. See how I've added the extra? And I'll put this parallel. The great thing about this is this print.
You can see right through the
tissue. I can see through it.
And, you don't
and it's
have...
printed. See, on the, it's got a little design in it. But ordinarily, you'd be going over. See, it has to be the same distance away from the selvage.
So this was 14.
This has to be 14. Okay.
Now, would you tape this down all the way around?
No,
with, like,
what I would
tape?
Do is I just put a little pin there. I usually use, they're called silk pins, and I don't have them now. And so what I do is I will pin them in the seam allowance.
Okay, parallel to the cutting edge.
Yes, and so kind of close. And remember, you're going through.
I'm pinning through the tissue as well,
tissue
underneath.
As well, because we're going to cut through everything.
So we have tissue, which is your pattern, the fashion fabric, and then two layers of tissue on the other side.
Now we've got a little extra problem with this. I thought we could teach a lot of things at once. This fabric has some sheen to it. So that means that when I cut my next piece, you see, it will have to go in the same direction.
So you're cutting on the bias with nap.
Right, with nap. Because if I switched it and did this, do you see?
Right.
Then one side would be shiny and one side wouldn't be. Okay, so they have to be in the same direction.
So you could see, how wide is this fabric? 60?
I think this happened to be 60. Have you seen scissors over there? You're always taking the good ones.
Here's the good one.
I just want to show you then how this begins to shape up.
Okay.
So just leave it. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm cutting through the tissue paper and through the pattern. And it's very accurate. You see that? I'm not getting any moving around or anything.
Nothing's wiggling.
If you've ever cut bias before, you've seen how uneven it can be.
Right.
So, now remember though, this, I've got a big seam allowances. So I would go around this and cut all the way around the whole thing.
And you'd only add that 1 inch to your side seams,
to the side seams only, okay? So let's move this off for a second, and then we'll have the fun of sewing it. So we've got, I have another one cut out.
Okay.
And you know, just remember this technique. Whenever you're cutting out silk, it wouldn't have to be on the bias, but it ends up being the same thing. You have to cut through the tissue paper. Now, I have two pieces. And the question is, here's one that you threw in there. And there's another one.
Is that another one? I think you threw that in there.
I didn't. There it is. Okay. All right. So move that
you
over
got,
to the
You
right.
got it, my
there, I've got the two now. Okay. So here they are. They're cut out. And what I have is I did a little bit of that stay tape on the shoulder. Mm-hmm. All right. Now, ordinarily, I would do it on both shoulders, but there's so many things I want to show you that I'm going to go ahead. So now, this we're going to do right sides together like this. And put the neck. Let's see here. Here we go. And we're going to sew. And so what we're going to sew together is the neck and the side seams. Now the side seams, what we want to do is everything's 5/8 except for the side seams. So what you want to do over there, Ron, is to pin these like this and keep it in the seam allowance.
Okay.
But now let's see, let me just show you, slide this over for a second. Oftentimes with bias, when you go to sew the side seams, do you see how one can seem like it's longer than the other? Just move it around a little bit. See, what you want to do is you want to start like this with the top and bottom ends and then just kind of lie it flat.
Okay.
Now, if one seems a lot bigger than the other, the question you should be asking yourself is, why I didn't cut through tissue paper, like Sandra said, or this is the worst piece of fabric I've ever had. And if it is bigger, let's say I've got this situation where it's this much bigger. Don't cut the little one off.
Or don't cut the big one off.
I mean the big one. Don't cut the big one off, but make it fit. Okay. You see?
Could you bring your tissue pattern piece back into play?
Yes.
And
what I would do is I'd put the smaller one on the top. And now, one of the things you might want to do, Ron, is get that blue painter's tape out of the box over there. Because the next thing we're going to do is sew our side seams. Okay?
With blue painter's tape.
Well, no, we want to put the blue painter's tape 1 5/8 inch over from the needle. Okay, so you're going to lay it over there on the machine.
Okay,
do you want this?
Sure, let's go, because we got...
So 1 5/8. Now, what needle do you have?
That is, well, we have, I'm in the machine right now, my friend, I don't know.
You probably have a denim needle. What you want in there is a 7010 HJ or a 659 HJ or HM. Those are really sharp points. And either cotton or silk thread, because what we want is we want to be sewing with a thread that is compatible with this lightweight fabric. Okay.
Okay.
Now, what you're going to do is I want you to put your zigzag stitch on the width of one.
The width of one.
And the length of 2.5.
Okay. 1 and 2.5.
And when you begin sewing, pull at the back of the thread. See, this is slippery, slimy fabric.
Whew.
You've got to get it started.
Jeez. Now, why aren't you doing this?
Look, are you sewing 1 5/8?
No, I'm not, because
there's a lot to think about.
That's
you said you wanted to learn about bias.
This is like driving a standard the very first time.
And so you're being careful not to stretch it.
Okay,
you're
so
just kind of pushing it.
Just let it kind of do its own thing here.
Okay, but don't sew deeper than 1 5/8.
Okay.
Or then it's going to be too small.
This is all over the place.
Got you at last.
Yeah, you did. Okay. Now, you know what? I have sewn bias before. Men's ties.
Uh-huh.
They're entirely cut on the bias. But usually they're
Their fabric is not quite as light as this one.
This is crazy.
All right. Now I'm going to get out the iron.
Okay. Could I sew over the pins if I really have to?
All right, just sew one side, because what I'm going to do is show you how to press it.
Okay.
Isn't that fun?
Not really. But it's looking pretty good.
It is. You did a good job.
Thank you.
All right, and if you want to look at it, now why did I use the zigzag stitch? Because this fabric on the bias stretches, and I want to give my seam a little stretch too.
A little bounce to it.
Because if I would have had a straight stitch, then it draws up.
Okay.
So the next thing you do is you press it as stitched.
But you're not stretching it. You're
not
just
stretching
just
it.
Pressing it flat.
Now this one, let's see, let's unpin this for a second because it's easier to do it just one side at a time. Then you open it up and you press it open.
Mm-hmm.
Now this time you can stretch it a little bit. And you know how they always say, let a bias garment hang for 24 hours
before?
All right. On a blouse, I wouldn't do this, but on a skirt, I would take and I would pull as I press it so that that'll take the stretch out. Because bias always ends up with kind of a wonky hem. Now, the reason you leave, now see these you can leave open,
mm-hmm.
because if otherwise they'll ripple, and then you give it a press from the top size. Okay. Now why was the seam so big? If you sew a little one, if you've ever sewn with bias and you sew a little one, it stretches so mm-hmm. much, and we want this to be the same length. Okay, and we leave that seam just like that.
Now, if you didn't want this big seam allowance, you could trim it down. Now.
Yeah, what I
sometimes. But after you try it on.
After I try it on, and then I might just cut right next to it, or I might serge the two together.
Right.
But you definitely want to get it right the first time. Now the next problem area will be the hem.
Mm. Do you want to do the hem?
Well, I knew you were going to say that. So, what I do for the hem is I put something called fusible thread on the bobbin and regular thread on the top.
That fusible thread, is that made by Coats or is it more than one company?
I think they more than one company have it now. And so what you do is you just stitch maybe 3/8 mm-hmm. or a half inch from the edge, and remember the right side up, and you see the fusible threads on the bottom.
So the fusible thread's in the bobbin. Right?
That's
now,
right.
Do you hand wind that, or do
no,
you?
No, you don't have to. Okay. It doesn't stretch. Now, what we want to do, can you see that there?
Yes.
And now okay. What we want to do is take this and press this right along the edge so that that melts.
Oh.
Then next, what I do is I take and trim this. Now you're going to say, well, why didn't you just sew on the edge? Well, if you try to sew on the edge with fabric like this, it will pull it right down into the bobbin.
Okay.
So I'm cutting close to that stitching line.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm rolling it again, enclosing that so you don't even see it anymore.
Oh, I see.
And then you can either do it by machine or hand. Now, why don't you sew this by the machine, and I'll show you how it will not. See, what happens is, this is such a cool technique, because usually when you try, I mean, we've got everything bad going on here. We've got bias, we've got slippery fabric, so this would just be stretching all out of place. But when you do that fusible thread thing and melt it, the fusible thread melts, but the other thread stays in there and acts as like a little interfacing. So now you can just sew that.
Regular stitch length?
You can sew regular stitch length, but not a notch on the bias now.
Okay. I'm liking this.
Okay.
Let's give that a pressing.
All right, so there it is. And of course, you'd have batching thread.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, it didn't get all wobbly.
Right.
Okay, so that's a trick.
I was pretty close to the edge there, too.
Uh-huh. Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's really flat.
It's really a pretty cool way to do it. Now, let's say we were making a bias skirt. Okay, here's an example. I made a coat out of this, and so that it would drape, I cut it on the bias. Now, for some reason, when you take a heavy fabric and try to do a hem like this, mm-hmm. it never works. So what I do, let's pretend I have a skirt made out of this, and I would go over there and I'd intentionally stretch the whole thing.
Press
once it's
it
sewn,
okay.
Stretch the whole thing, do a little hem marker, and now I have it even all the way at the bottom. So I would cut my hem.
Now, once you press it, would it stretch out in some areas more
than
others?
Oh, definitely, okay. Definitely.
So you'd put the pattern piece back over top.
No, I wouldn't put the pattern piece. I'd do one of those hemmers from the floor.
Okay, right.
And then I would cut it off a half inch lower than the marking where I want it to be. So now what I'm going to do is take a fabric. This is that wide double fold bias. And so what we want to do is we want to sew this right sides together. So I want you to sew this. Let's see, the right side of this is here. Okay. So here it is. Okay. So sew this at a quarter inch, sewing in that crease. All right? But sewing on the bias on top so it stretches just slightly as you sew it on.
Okay.
Now, why are you doing that? Because when I turn this up, you see this circumference is going to be bigger than what it's going to go up on.
Right.
So what I want you to do
is sew and stretch.
Sew and stretch. Oh, gosh. That's right.
And they wondered why I don't wear women's clothes.
So you're stretching the bias and you're not stretching the garment.
Okay. So here we go.
And you're sewing in that little crease.
And you could only stretch, well, I guess you could only stretch this so much, but
you get the hang of it after a while. All right. Now, once we do that, then what we do is see, you did a good job, and now you press this away from your fabric.
And the seam allowances are going down towards the bias strip.
And then what you have is it goes like this. Let's see. This turns up. Let me just get this. So I'm sorry, I pressed it the wrong way. The seam allowance goes up into the garment.
Okay.
Okay? Because it like fills it in, I'll show you here. Because what this does is, see, you turn it right on that.
Oh, it creates a little fold.
Yeah, it creates a little fold. So, and so what you do here is you pin that up. And the reason you stretched it is because you wanted this to fit nice and flat. See, that got rolled out a little bit. But remember when we first did the sew fabric and pulled it up, how bulky it was. Now this lies perfectly flat.
And you would hand stitch that down.
I would hand stitch it. You would probably machine stitch it. So since you like that idea, I want you to machine stitch here.
Okay.
And then I want you to do the same thing down here. So it looks good. Do
like
it on both.
Like a double wide edge stitching, top stitching.
That's right.
Okay.
Okay, now I would not do it on the bias. I would do it on the straight of the grain. I mean, I wouldn't do it a zigzag.
Oh, I see.
Okay, and the one other thing you always have to remember about bias is I feel, store it flat. If you have a bias garment and it's in something like silk, like this one I'm making, if I took that out of the closet, it would get long and skinny. Ideally, you just have it folded. Whereas on this linen dress, because the linen is so strong, I can hang it. How's it looking over there?
Not so bad. Not so
bad.
Okay.
All right. And you know, I always like to do you don't have to do a contrasting color, but it's a nice surprise. When you cross your legs, you know, the whole idea with bias is it's a little bit sexy. So there you would have your two rows of stitching.
Right.
Let's press it a little bit with our press cloth that we can't find. And we'll put a little paper on it. And you never press back and forth like this.
Just up and down.
Up and down. It's called press and lift. And so that, if you did it on the bias, mm-hmm. see, that would be great. Mm-hmm. So you could, you don't have to do it by hand. But if you do it by hand, it remains completely invisible.
Right.
So that's all I know about bias. Let's see, there's one last thing I do know. If you have, to add insult to injury, two or three bias seams that go across this way.
Right.
All right, then I would take those, I'd sew those with a little stay tape so they don't get too long.
Would you fuse the stay tape on like you
on
did
the
with
seam.
The, on the seam like you did with the shoulder?
So what I would do is like here, the any area you think is going to be a big problem. See, if you had this big cross seam, mm-hmm. you would just stay tape that, and that would keep it from getting even worse. Okay. So those are the secrets of bias. Thank you for watching.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.